form and aim for another top 10 finish.
Hey guys, what's going on everybody? Hey, we're in the Netherlands today at the new Zandvoort track. And it's a nice, beautiful, rainy day. Let's go ahead and jump into it and see what we can do. We're actually on pole position right now, so everything's looking pretty good. Keep it clean on T1 here. There we go. Go ahead and apply a little bit of overtake. Even though you gotta watch it up through here. I have wrecked a few times going through there. Oh shit. Right as I fucking speak about it. Alright.
Okay, that's a good start. Keep it up.
This car has actually been lacking a lot of rear downforce the whole weekend. And, I just put in for actually a major upgrade for my rear downforce package, so that should be available here. Maybe next race? I'm not sure. But definitely lack of grip out here on the track. Massive lack of grip. Gotta be careful. Gotta be careful back there. That was my teammate right there, Callum Ilott, that just retired from the session.
Dropped out of the race.
Yeah, Callum's been having a very rough season. Not going well for him.
Yellow flag. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead.
Thank you.
Okay, clear.
There's a lot of standing water back there. Trying to at least build up a second gap in between me and LeClaire here. Even though he doesn't have DRS, it's raining, so there's not going to be DRS for the whole race. Very difficult to pass.
We'll be seeing at least 20 minutes of light rain.
Yikes.
sets a new fastest lap of the race.
Third gear here. So yeah, that seems to work a lot better. Riding third back there too. Second just made me get a snap oversteer. Lock up. See if I can get away with running lean on air for a few laps. Just in case I need to come back at the end on Ridge. Forgot about third there. Yeah, so far lean mode is actually working really well.
Use your overtake button more. It's time to utilize some of this energy.
Wondering what assist that I'm using. Obviously you see the lines on the curves, the turns. I'm still learning the tracks, so for me this is pretty essential. And then right now I'm running medium traction control. So those are the only two assists that I have on currently. And my AI driver difficulty level is set to 70%. And I actually found that F12020, the AI, is way more advanced than 2019, I think. The pace seems to be, I don't know, a lot faster, the stats and everything seem to be more realistic, so, shit. You don't want to venture down there. Just stop talking, start racing.
You're going to start losing some tire grip around now.
crap. Yeah, I'm definitely the, I can feel it on the rear tires.
That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up.
Update here. Race update.
Repeat that. There's interference.
There's always interference, Jeff. Full race update.
You're leading the pack. P1. Leclerc is behind you. Our gap behind is 1.6 seconds. They're on old inters. Your pit window is open. Pit window is open. 7 laps to go.
Try third in T1 here. That was not the fastest way around there, that's for sure. Yeah, that right front tire does not look fast. Super wide there. That was not the place to run wide, that's for sure.
5 laps of fuel remaining.
Botas trying to take the fastest lap.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Yeah, it seems like track conditions are changing pretty rapidly on the track, actually, and lap times are dropping because of it. You know, my right front tire isn't the best. It's just 3.2 second gap in between me and Leclerc, so... ...34%? Wasn't it just at 27? How the fuck does it go up?
This is your final lap of the race. Left of this rain, then we think it's going to dry up. 10 minutes.
Oh, crap. Yeah, that did do it. I'm not gonna get the fastest lap on this one. Hopefully nobody takes my fastest lap here. Alright, let's bring it in.
Great job, you've done everything we wanted today.
Man, that was actually, it's actually quite a challenging track in the rain. A lot of off-camber.
Many doubted whether they could pull off the win here in Zandvoort, but they have done, and done it in spectacular style.
in the pouring rain.
What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
It's a heroic effort for any driver to race in conditions like these. And
some good old-fashioned gasoline.
Very special indeed. They were able to find all the grip, all the good lines, and have the confidence to get on the power to top it all off. That's what pushed them into first place here today.
You're battling for it? No shit.
A show-stopping performance from the three drivers approaching the podium right now. It's been an interesting Grand Prix, that's for sure.
I like your dance. Awesome. Alright, so that should have increased our championship lead. No doubt about that. Bring us up to the 12th tier. And the 13th tier. Sweet.
Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Jackson increases their championship lead. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Well, it's absolutely got to be Alexander Albon, no hesitation. He put in a performance today that's only going to build further upon his already growing reputation.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.
Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I really appreciate it. I'm going to keep this content coming at you. This is just my first race series in F1 2020, my team, and racing for Conte Engineering. So let's keep it going. We'll keep it going strong. And come back soon. Thanks, guys. I'll see you later. Take it easy.